So I have a lot of more optimization to do, in fact. So we have a couple of daemons already, or application domains, I guess. TFVFSD, session bus daemons, user session bus daemons, and user applications. Now we have a couple more to do, actually a bunch more. Let's just start by gsession. Start with gsession. So we have started by user gsession. And then go to debus. Copy over that. This one here. And then go to gsession. So the idea of all this optimization is to basically decrease the footprint. But also to make it more readable. But performance and efficiency is the primary goal. This probably does need a base template as well as a as a normal template. So gsession. All user gsession domains. Alright, so we have that set up. Let's just copy over some of this stuff just for a reference if we need it. Let's go to our interface file. I'll just paste this in here, but not sure if I'm going to need it. So we have this user app. So basically, we need them both. And we also need this one here. Alright, so let's change this. To create an app based domain, a gsession to create gsession based domains. To create a user, to create user gsession domains. And let's start above. User session. Started by user tsesh. And this is actually session. And then here just some unknown user G session. And this is still the base app domain template, but this is here actually the user G session. This should be it. And this basically user G session. Yeah, so that's basically, I'll just copy this over. This is the base and this is the normal one. Back to our type working file. So now we have to look for user for these session started domains. So for example, here we have one. Now since this so now I'm confused already again. Oh yeah, I did that for because there's a dependency there. But might as well just edit the whole thing here. Let's first just edit this one here. So it's actually a base in this case. Okay, but it's not actually. Yeah, we need to put that in there. But this one here. I forgot why I actually did this this way. Doesn't make sense. Ha. seem to make sense, but I might be actually wrong, but this can be removed. Actually, that's the issue, isn't it? Now I understand what the issue was. The issue is that the name is the issue here. The name of the executable file. That's why. And the same probably, yeah, the same applies for this one. So that's why it's not working. So yeah, this is a special case. I'm using G session. Started by. You can't use the base template here because, simply because. That makes me wonder. That makes me wonder. Let's just move on. We have the same issue. Oh, not quite. This is not quite the same issue because here the executable file is actually. The same way, but I don't understand this one here. Gonna open a new shell here. Base app domain template actually provides this. So why am I driving? Because the base app domain provides it, but base domain doesn't. This is it. Oh yeah, that's because the apps clears an executable file, I guess. It does actually make me wonder. I'm kind of confused. Oh, this is it. This is it. Yeah, that seems to be fine. I'm kind of confused. I forgot a little bit how this works. How this works. Also trying to imagine, oh yeah, this was also because of that executable file type. This name was not the same as the domain name. Well, actually, yeah, that's actually true. Although I could change the name. Here we have another one. This is actually also a base domain. Sessions from it. See, I need to be careful that I don't break stuff. See, it does make things a little bit more complicated. Okay, so that's set up. Now this one is actually not a base domain, this is just a full domain. So, the session domain. And then we can actually remove the... this stuff. Here we have one that is actually also single. This one also with no base. Another one. Now this is a, if anything, now this is a, isn't even in a D session one. VD agent is and all these domains also need the file descriptor to the user, I guess, or maybe you can actually don't audit them, I'm not sure yet. This is a base. Because it's shared. This optimization work actually it's a pretty big task. Okay, so that should be taken care of that. PA is not started by session. This is accessing both domains. It's dsets, there's also plenty dset domains. So that's probably the next one I'll do. Dsession is actually now yeah, I'm just yeah, it seems just that this shell is just a desession domain, so can't fuck with that. So if chest it is, then it is desession domain. Simple as that. We have another dsession on, but this is actually a shared, so yes, come on. Oops. Let's just remove these opening brackets first. Take care of that. This is the session domain all the way. As well. Track minor is also desession all the way. TR minor FS. Sets as well. A only started by a session, so that makes it a session domain all the way. As the applet, same. Not a brace though. Damn, I need to stay focused. And here we have a user session bus, but it's also a G session. So, tr store, so this is base. And then we can remove this one here. Same here. XDG, there, update. This is both a user application and a G session. And the user application will already take care of. Canberra, also G session based, but also started by transmission GTK, so. I need to just remove. Yeah, there's various options. Base domain or full domain, and it can even be none of those two in the first place, because if the executable file has a different prefix than the domain type, then you can't actually use any of these templates, and then you'll have to just use raw. It's also a D-session domain, but it's a full D-session domain. So no base. Taken care of. This seems to be taken care of. User session both domain. Calf factory session both domain. Cal D also session both domain. This not applicable for this one. Seems. Session passing and it's also not applicable. Also not. Session bus also not applicable. Session bus, user session bus also not. Service provider also not. This one is also not. which is actually also, we should just undo that. But this is one way to do it, I guess. Not trying to make it too complicated. Just trying to make it as optimized as possible without being too much shit. Shell a domain and a Nautilus domain. There's also G-shell domain. G-shell domain. G-shell domain. First and first. G-shell domain. I think we're probably done with the session domains. We have a G-shell domain. G-shell, I need G-session. Stupid. I'm working on G-session, not G-shell. This is the session, you know, the and it's not a base template, it's just an X. Although you could run this actually from manually, you could run any of these programs manually, but first and foremost, it's just the session domain. oops, shell domain, exec domain, syslog domain, shell domain, policy git out domain, session bus domain, here we have one. Yeah, that's possibly it. Bug. And it's an interface file, I guess. Okay, this is at least built. So let's just do the same thing for these settings. Yeah, we gotta keep moving. There's just a lot of work to do. TZD. Those are not my many domains. It gets started at TZD, so. And then tset. Now let's just go to dbusd again. Dbusd. And then tset. then it's deceptive. So that should be taken care of. Let's set up these templates. So we have a base and a normal one. Although I'm pretty sure there's no actual normal gset domain. So I'll just remove this one here. Template to create a user gset D. Gset D. Oh, and this is a bug. This is a bug, I need to fix that. So that's in this the way I do this, I actually find bugs. I basically automatically by copying the previous templates, I'm basically overviewing the previous template, double checking it, and then I find bugs. So that's one way of checking it, I guess. So we have to use a gset based domain. Gset based domain. Now we have to go through all these things again. This is a special one, the keyring daemon. But this is taken care of now. Actually, I forgot to remove this stuff here. Make sure that I don't mess stuff up. So I'm looking for gset domains. And there aren't many. a very few. Here we have another one. Oh, and here we have another one, which is actually a base domain. Funk. Which is actually a base domain. So. I'll just add that. Didn't think I would see any of them, but there's actually one. So, template to create a user, gset the domain, and then gset the domain. Actually one of those. I'll send a base domain here. This is a base domain. Okay, let's see if we can find others. This is decision domain. Shell domain. I think we probably now all have all the gsetting domains, gset daemon domains. So I seem to remember that there weren't many. Oh, here we have another one. No, actually not. No. We're probably done now. Yeah, we're probably done. Probably done. Unknown titles, audio exactly. At line 1372. So. Yeah, we have we're getting into some issues. Optional policy issues again. This one needs to go inside here, and then we have a bunch of stuff that needs to get in there. This one here, for example. Unknown titles, audio, 1374. Why is that unknown type? Pulse audio, exactly. Yeah. Here we have the same issue as I'm curing diamonds. Oh, there's also a typo in there. I'll be glad when we get all these domain transitions out of the way, because this is kind of confusing indeed. So let's just start and see where we hit a brick wall. Gnome shell. G shell. G hell. G shell. Let's do this. Copy that over. Go to GHEL. And then add that in all the way below. Edit that. Now, how does that run Nautilus work? Shouldn't be hit any conflicts there. Although, not sure. Alright, now let's just do all the T-shell domains. Unfortunately, we're done with the queuing daemon. And that's fortunate. We're also, for now, done with debugs. Domain started by G-shells start pretty low. So here we have one. up another one. Give me a sec, mom. There's also a special case this with the lapity shit. So I've GNOME actually gets run by Nautilus, but it also runs Nautilus. this is actually a G shell only one. Same for this. This gets run by more than single thingy. Down here, which is also on the shell. not beige, man. Oh, this is a beige one. This is a good bait, this is also beige one. So not sure if you hear that music in the background. But those are roofers, and they have those big radios, and they listen to real gay music. So I really feel sorry for some of those roofers that really can't actually stand it, but that music. But if they say so, then they probably get fired. So they basically have to put up with that music, which for people like me would really be hell. This is such wrong music. If I had to work in that with that music all day, then I would go crazy in no time. Okay, so this is actually not a app domain template. So yeah, you need to be careful here. And actually probably need to basically put this in a optional block. I would probably go crazy. Oh, and actually this is not even going to work. This is one of those things again. that should be okay. Not sure. We'll see. Data prefs. Oops. I think it might be a good time to actually test this shit again. Just a small test to see whether everything still boots up in the proper domains. We have it 11.53. Seems to still be all running. So let's just try one thing out. Let's just see if we can actually do this. And then from the menu run Yelp. Seems to work. Still. Still clean. So it seems that the domain transitions for now are still proper. Looks all proper when I look at it. So yeah, I guess for now we still haven't made it, and that's a wonder in itself. So that's a wonder and it's all by itself. So we got actually to 519. So the last one was 527. So we actually managed to get 8k out of this stuff. So that's 8k improvement when it comes to footprint. So that's yeah. So now let's just start started by Nautilus, created started by Nautilus. There's not many, but each byte is one. Each byte is one. So start by using out. Or not. Like it's Monday again. This probably doesn't need a full domain. Exiting and stuff like that. There's not many that started by you in Nautilus, got just a couple. But then it gets harder to find them, of course. Actually, It's confusing as hell. This is confusing as hell. But I guess it works. Again. Okay. Actually, oh, this is not itself. Pretty darn confusing. But optimization is king. Especially with these bosses like these that are so very large. We have another one. Probably a good idea to leave it kind of this way. With regard to the transitions, for now at least. Make a run, spools audio. So Canberra and start Fox PA. So Canberra and South PA. Let's see if they have some other options, more options. I don't think so. Oh yeah, well, we do run steepers. I'll just copy this over just for is launch in XP. And we just launch. I'm set check T domain probably. Runs the best. Still 519, so that didn't really help us that much. So I am set check T. And let's just in set check. That's one, it runs dubious lines. That's basically all it is. Yeah, so that's not worth it. Do we have any other stuff? Decent locale though. Decent locale exec. This might be one. guess let's just look through it. My login user. So we have dset get run by it. And we have dsd print to get run by it. And these settings getting run by it. So this actually worth it. So gset locale exec domain. Yeah. That's actually kind of worth it. Set the locale exec. Set the locale exec. What a name. Set the locale exec. All user gset the locale exec domains. Gset the locale exec. Set the locale exec. Set the locale exec. Set the locale exec. Actually, I should just copy this over. Not that worth it, but it's at least a little bit worth it. So that's that. You said the locale exec. Set the locale exec. Set the locale exec. Set the locale exec. So we have one. This is not it. Here we have another one. That's it. Okay. Oops. EM said the my login user EM said DT. Settings. That's it, so that's not worth it. I'm going to take a break. If it builds.